RN, BSN, LPN, ASN, DNP, PhD, what do all of these acronyms mean? Let's discuss nursing as a profession. Nursing is a profession because it requires specialized and often prolonged education and training. These programs will eventually lead to the ultimate goal, which is licensure. To be licensed means you have the legal authority to practice as a nurse, whether LPN, RN, CRNA, or ARNP. Now, it's very important to differentiate between education and your role. When we talk about education, we're talking about the different degrees, like ASN, BSN, MSN, DNP, or PhD. When you hear LPN, RN, ARNP, CRNA, that is focusing on the role. Now, there are different educational paths one can take to get to a different role. LPN. To become an LPN, you must first go to a practical or vocational school. LPN, or Licensed Practical Nurse, or LVN, Licensed Vocational Nurse, focuses on the bedside care and the practical or hands-on aspects of nursing. They do work under the supervision of a registered nurse. Schooling takes about a year and a half. After you successfully pass your class and graduate, you will get your certificate or an associate's degree depending on the program that you choose. That's your education. Then you will be able to sit for your NCLEX PN. When you pass, you will be licensed to work as an LPN or an LVN. To become a registered nurse, you must attend a program that offers an associate's or bachelor's degree. Associate's degree programs are about 2 years in length. Bachelor's degrees, about 4 years if you're straight out of high school and have no prior degrees. Now, there are students who have prior degrees in other areas, for example, a bachelor's in health sciences, who wish to become registered nurses. They don't necessarily have to go back to school for another 4 years. After you finish your schooling, clinicals, and you graduate, you can sit for the NCLEX RN. You pass, you get your license, and you can legally work as a registered nurse. Bridge programs. Bridge programs are popping up everywhere. Bridge programs are a way to allow students who have prior educational background and training to begin training at a higher level without starting everything from the beginning and repeating a lot of the courses that are already been completed. For example, if you are an LPN and you wish to become an RN, there are bridge programs in place like the LPN to RN that will take into consideration some of your prior completed coursework. And if you're an RN with an associate's degree and you wish to obtain a bachelor's degree, you can sign up for a program like the RN to BSN that educates the RN with an associate's degree into an RN with a bachelor's degree. At the graduate level, you can obtain a master's, a doctorate, or a PhD. Now, with the Master's of Science in Nursing, you can study to become a nurse practitioner, a clinical nurse specialist, CRNA, nurse educator, or even a nurse administrator. DNP and PhD. Now, while they are both terminal degrees, each track has a specific focus. The PhD track focuses on original research. The DNP track, however, focuses on practice improvement, meaning the student in the DNP program is able to critique and analyze research findings. Then they use these findings, put them into practice to make changes and improve their organization. This is the implementation of research. And finally, a very special focus on the CNA. Now, many nurses started their career by becoming a CNA, a certified nursing assistant. CNAs are the eyes and ears of the LPN and the RN. They work under the supervision of the LPN and the RN to assist patients with certain duties, including personal hygiene, dietary needs, ambulatory needs, and to help monitor the patient. In order to become a CNA, you must attend CNA classes offered by different community colleges, vocational schools, and even certain medical facilities.